Good morning, students. Today we are beginning chapter 2 in geography, physical features of India. Topics for discussion are varied physical features, theory of plate tectonics, and formation of Himalayas. India is a land of varied physical features. In fact, India has all the physical features of the earth, that is mountains, plateaus, plains, deserts and islands. How these physical features have been formed? The physical features of India have evolved through different geological periods. During the process of their formation, they have been given their present form by erosion, weathering, and deposition. The earth scientists have given number of theories for the formation of physical features. But the most accepted theory is the theory of plate tectonics. This theory was given by Alfred Wegener. According to this theory, the crust of the earth has been formed out of 7 major and some minor plates. These 7 major plates are Pacific, North American, South American, African, Eurasian, Indo-Australian, and Antarctic. These plates are not stable. They keep on moving due to the convectional currents which rises up in the magma which lies beneath these plates. The movements of these plates causes stresses within the plates and the continental rocks above that, which leads to folding, faulting, and volcanic activity. Let's see how faults takes place. When two plates move towards each other, the sedimentary rock which lies in between starts rising up. They get folded and thus leads to the formation of fold mountains. Likewise, when the two plates move away from each other, a crack or fold appears in between that results in the formation of rift valleys. Likewise, the volcanoes are located on the plate margins. These movements of plates can be classified in 3 ways. First one is the convergent boundary. These type of boundaries are formed when two plates move towards each other. Divergent boundaries are formed when two plates move away from each other. And the third type of boundary, the transform boundary, is formed when two plates move horizontally past each other. Now, let's see how this theory of plate tectonics applicable to the formation of Himalayas. The peninsular India is the oldest landmass of India. It was the part of Gondwanaland. The Gondwanaland originally consisted of South America, Africa, Antarctica, Australia, as well as the Indian subcontinent altogether. The convectional currents splitted the crust of the Gondwanaland into number of smaller plates. As these plates were moving, the Indo-Australian plate drifted northward and collided with the much bigger Eurasian plate. Due to this collision, the sedimentary rocks which were accumulated in the geosyncline of Tethys Sea, they started rising up and thus leading to the formation of Himalayas. Thank you and have a nice day.